What's going on, guys? I'm Purple Boy, and I'm back at it again with another Express review. This time, we're talking about The Commuter. After the third Taken film, I kind of felt like it was time for Liam Neeson to kind of just take a back seat to these action thrillers, because we've seen him in this role so many times that it's really getting played out and very tired. But for some reason, he squeezes out just enough juice to make this film work. One of the more interesting things about this film are the bystanders that actually are caught in between this cat and mouse game between the mysterious woman and Liam Neeson's character. And I feel like if you would have taken Liam Neeson's character out of the film and focused on the bystanders and maybe their dynamic and their relationship with one another, it probably would have made for a more interesting film. Now, don't get it twisted. It doesn't mean that the film isn't very generic and very predictable, but it just barely crossed that line of being mildly entertaining. There is one particular action sequence I thought was shot really well, and it looked cool. Despite those moments where I was engaged in the mystery and the action that was happening on screen, the film still reminded me that this was a train ride I had taken far too often, and the final destination was not a surprise at all. Alright guys, so that's my Express review for The Commuter. I have more Express reviews up for a lot of new releases and older ones. Go ahead and go check that out on my Instagram page or my YouTube channel. Follow me on Twitter as well. Thank you so much for watching.